2018 Jaguar XF Saloon Review. The good points of Jaguar XF Saloon. Elegant, athletic design. Engaging handling. Technology laden. Efficient engines. The bad points of Jaguar XF Saloon. Petrol versions thirsty. Cabin less interesting. Rivals feel more luxurious. Unsporty diesel engines. Replacing a vehicle that heralded a whole new start for any brand is rather an ominous task, but the second generation Jaguar XF Saloon has proved over up to the project. It is usually a more careful evolution from the four-door coupe shape. Nonetheless, it's made to be dramatic and bristling with subtle detailing. It remains more athletic than its key rivals too, including the Audi A6, BMW 5 Series and Mercedes-Benz E-Class, aside from a more left-field choice such as the Lexus GS. Lighter and even more spacious. Despite being fractionally shorter reducing than the last model, the Jaguar XF is quite a bit more spacious, thanks within a large part to your 51mm longer wheelbase, liberating more space for rear seat passengers. A 540-liter boot is another welcome benefit. It doesn't set class benchmarks for cabin roominess, nevertheless it's effective at carrying 2 6-foot-tall adults from the back without feeling cramped. Not only would be the cabin more spacious, it's created to feel airier too, thanks to some greater glass area, including the third side window just behind the trunk doors. This effectively lessens the feeling of claustrophobia often seen by backseat passengers. This generation of Jaguar XF is 190 kg lighter compared to previous model, and also the entry-level diesel model weighs 80 kg under its nearest competitor. It's also more aerodynamic drag coefficient of 0.26, which, with the weight reduction, lowers fuel consumption. Efficient suite of diesel and petrol engines. There are 8 engine options, 4 ones are diesels. These account for your bulk of XF sales. Available in 3 power outputs: -163 horsepower, 180 horsepower, and with twin turbos, 240 horsepower, the 2.0-liter diesel motors deliver performance that's commensurate while using Jaguar name. Captivating performance isn't what are the diesel XFs are only concerned with though. Low running prices are the focus. Find the 163 horsepower diesel together with the standard 6-speed manual gearbox and rear-wheel drive, and Jaguar claims about 70.6 miles per gallon and CO2 emissions of 104 gkm, one with the lowest with this segment for any non-hybrid powertrain. If you like petrol, 4-cylinder 2.0-liter turbo petrol engines can be purchased with outputs of 200 horsepower, 250 horsepower and 300 horsepower, the best XF with all-wheel drive. In fact, if you ever require the extra traction of most wheel drive, 2.0-liter engines are the only option. V6 models are rear-wheel drive only. All versions are paired using the excellent 8-speed automatic, which Jaguar expects for being the most popular choice for the XF one and also the 180 horsepower engine. Even in this particular guise, 65.7 miles per gallon is claimed, with emissions of 114 gkm for the back-wheel drive version. A 6-speed manual gearbox can be obtained on the 2-liter power diesels, if you want using a clutch or want the minimum possible emissions. V6 versions badged XFS. More performance is to be had with specification Jaguar XF Saloons. Both of them are 3.0-liter capacity V6 engines. One a twin-turbo diesel, one other a supercharged petrol shared together with a F-type, producing 300 horsepower and 380 horsepower, respectively. The 8-speed automatic could be the only transmission choice with such two. Both will reach a governed 155 miles per hour, with all the petrol version completing the 0.62 miles per hour sprint in 5.3 seconds, almost an extra quicker as opposed to V6 diesel's 6.2 seconds. Outright efficiency isn't the petrol's strong point, minus 34.0 miles per gallon and 198 gkm of CO2 reinforce that. However, the diesel more likely to be within the budget of countless motorists that has a claimed 51.4 miles per gallon and emissions of 144 gkm. Improved handling and steering. Engaging handling irrespective of version. Jaguar has embraced the benefits in the XF's light, stiff body to boost the car's handling and, despite its size, it feels nimble and lithe while you scythe through challenging bends. There's an electric-powered power-assisted steering system too that only delivers an outstanding degree of feel from the wheel. It improves fuel efficiency by 3% on the conventional hydraulic alternative. Further, you can find adaptive dampers to vary the sportiness on the handling, without compromising comfort, as well as a much-needed overhaul with the XF's infotainment features, with two versions of Jaguar's InTouch system available. The verdict. We have a very lot of time for your Jaguar XF. It's good to operate a vehicle, and, inside the right color and trim, looks hundreds of dollars. Is it a class-leading executive car, such as the original XF was if it was launched? Sadly not. Its choice of abilities is way too patchy, while using excellent dynamics and capable array of engines being compromised from the ultimate insufficient interior quality. And whenever you're on the BMW 5 Series and Mercedes-Benz D-Class, this is a problem. Watch the total Jaguar XF saloon review why this sporty four-door executive is stuck such high regard. Efficient four-cylinder petrols and diesels. More powerful 3.0-liter twin-turbo diesel available. Best for performance is 3.0-liter supercharged petrol. Performance and efficiency for your Jaguar XF range is delivered from an H-Tron lineup of diesel and petrol engines. Popular variety of diesels. Powering the bulk of Jaguar XF saloons could be the firm's four-cylinder imbuing category of diesels, created to deliver class-leading efficiencies without sacrificing performance. Entry denote the XF range may be the 2.0-liter diesel with 163 horsepower and 380 Nm of torque from 1,750 revolutions per minute. Using a choice of standard 6-speed manual and optional 8-speed automatic gearboxes. It's pleasingly brisk using a top speed of 132 miles per hour plus 0.62 miles per hour use of 8.7 seconds, regardless on the transmission. Efficiency is the place the transmission type makes a difference. The manual gearbox delivers class-leading figures of the claimed 70.6 miles per gallon and CO2 emissions of just 104 gkm, one from the best associated with a non-hybrid car in this particular segment. Choose the 180 horsepower version from the engine, badged 20D, and top speed climbs to 136 miles per hour while at 8.1 seconds the automatic's acceleration from standstill to 62 miles per hour can be a tenth of another slower as opposed to manual. While the engine sound isn't particularly characterful within a sporty sense, it's a refined smaller capacity diesel that feels flexible and linear to use power delivery when fitted while using auto box. If you need the all-wheel drive traction on the 20D AWD automatic, expect the superior speed to be pegged at 136 miles per hour, though the 0.62 miles per hour time stretches seem to 8.4 seconds. Called the 25D, The identical 2.0-liter engine fitted with two turbos produces 240 horsepower and 500 Nm of torque at 1,500 revolutions per minute. The automatic gearbox is standard, but no matter what, whether you are going for a corner wheel drive version in the 25DAWD, performance is similar at 153 miles per hour with 6.5 seconds required for that 0.62 miles per hour. On paper, those stats render the 30D featuring its 300 horsepower 3.0-liter V6 twin turbo somewhat redundant. However, this motor's limited in S and portfolio trims in support of with rear wheel drive. The automatic allows easy accessibility to the engine's colossal 700 Nm of torque. Whether coming from a standstill or awachi near motorway speeds, provoking the accelerator unleashes a blast at the of forward motion, permitting you to dispatch overtaking maneuvers with no trouble. Electronically governed at 155 miles per hour. Sprinting from 0.62 miles per hour takes just 6.4 seconds, yet Jaguar claims this XF will average 51.4 miles per gallon, while CO2 emissions can be a surprisingly modest 144 gkm. Quartet of petrol alternatives. Jaguar expanded its petrol range at the beginning of 2017 with 2.0-liter, 4-cylinder turbocharged ingenium units. All are fitted together with the 8-speed automatic transmission, producing 200 horsepower and 320 Nm of torque from 1,200 revolutions per minute would be the 20 tons. It's rear-wheel drive only and has now a top speed of 146 miles per hour, that has a 0.62 miles per hour use of 7.5 seconds. Power in the same basic engine is ramped nearly 250 horsepower with the 25 tons, with torque increased to 365 Nm. Rear and all-wheel drive minus 25 tons AWD, permutations can be obtained, both with 0.62 miles per hour times during 6.6 seconds. Top speeds differ though, RWD is 152 miles per hour. AWD 147 miles per hour, at the top in the 4-cylinder petrol range could be the 30P, with 300 horsepower and 400 Nm. Only offered in R-Sport or portfolio trim, this reaches 62 miles per hour in 5.8 seconds, and can carry on to your limited 155 miles per hour Jaguar claim 40 miles per gallon due to this version, with emissions of 163 gkm. XFS delivers ultimate performance. The ultimate XF with regards to performance may be the petrol 3.0-liter V6. This supercharged 380 horsepower unit delivers 450 Nm of torque to the spine wheels from your relatively high 4,500 revolutions per minute. While this means you must work the engine difficult to extract probably the most from it, it's at these higher revs in which the sound's far more dramatic. You can hear the supercharger in action when you hold on to each gear ratio, maximizing performance. While it's fast and also entertaining to operate a vehicle like this, the world thinks the punchier diesel version, featuring its slow-down torque, suits day-to-day driving within the XF slightly better. However, once you opt to operate a vehicle the petrol XF gently, the engine note is a lot more hushed and docile at urban speeds. Once again, the superior speed is electronically limited to 155 miles per hour, though the 0.62 miles per hour the no restrictions, taking just 5.3 seconds to finish the test. You'll pay for the pumps though, that has a claim of 34.0 miles per gallon and CO2 emissions of 198 gkm. Lightweight aluminium body tends to make agile handling. Buyers can pick different suspension setups. Revised steering delivers rewarding drive. Employing lightweight aluminium to the body not just makes the Jaguar XF particularly light and stiff, the resultant side effects is improved handling within the outgoing version. Comfort and agility. This only tells part with the story though, for Jaguar is definitely lauded with the comfort of that cars along with the XF isn't it different, picking out the optimum suspension setup helps. The double wishbone front suspension is made in such a way that maximizes tire contact together with the road whether in a very straight line or cornering, delivering agility that belies the XF's size. At the back is an integral link system that allowed Jaguar's engineers greater treating both handling characteristics and ride quality. It feels uncanny that a motor vehicle which changes direction with your poise can ensure its passengers remain unruffled. Different suspension setups available. Standard fit suspension dampers happen to be improved in order for the faster you're going, the stiffer they become to help handling. Adaptive dampers can also be found, enhancing the experience further still. Even in their firmest setting, the XF transmits few serious bumps through for the cabin, yet it feels more composed and confidence-inspiring through top speed corners. Configurable dynamics, on V6 engine versions, allows the driving force to further adjust throttle response, gear change points and steering weight in addition on the suspension. Rewarding they are driving. The XF steering is currently an electrically power-assisted system for greater fuel efficiency, and it also feels immediate, accurate along with well-weighted responses. Steering action is further enhanced with torque vectoring by braking TVBB, another technology seen first inside the range around the F-type, which gently brakes the within wheels through bends, mitigating the chances from the XF pushing wide into understeer. The brakes feel impressive too, delivering excellent retardation with negligible proof fading despite repeated heavy use. They're an easy task to modulate too, permitting gentle slowing. Cabin lacks the initial XF's wow factor. Remains an opulent place to invest some time. In control touch pro multimedia pack impressed. This second generation Jaguar XF's interior is impressive but it really lacks the theater of that predecessor. Those revolving air vents survive but now exactly the outer ones feature the startup drama as being the central pair are slender and fixed, they don't even rise inside a pod just like the F-types. They've moved for functional reasons, though, as being the cutout from the dash is often a one-size-fits-all slot for the 2.8-inch in-control multimedia system plus the new, in-control Touch Pro system having its 10.2-inch touchscreen. Both systems offer a much better clarity of graphics than seen inside previous XF, the screen is a bit more responsive to touches and there's greater connectivity than before, including a Wi-Fi hotspot with around 8 connections. If you upgrade towards the Touch Pro system, your clear and well-presented analog dials that has a small digital screen with shot and non-shot are replaced with a 12.3-inch screen per the Jaguar XJ. The XF second evolution, though, features sharper graphics and continues for being adaptable in their appearance. Elsewhere the remainder in the cabin seems like a combination of old XF, particularly while using broad aluminium plinths throughout the dash, as well as the latest XJ with all the Riva hoop dash that brand of veneer trim, that splays on the doors and tempts the base on the windscreen. Only portfolio models use a leather suede dashboard, the remainder use a heavily grained soft touch plastic that looks a bit too coarse in texture for that sophisticated interior. Also debuting around the XF is laser-based head-up display HUD unit, projecting extremely sharp and colorful graphics for speed and setting of instructions direction to the windscreen. The unit itself looks rather crudely grafted to the top on the instrument binnacle. Easier to get involved with the more spacious cabin. Rivals remain roomier, though. Adaptive suspension costs its passengers. Jaguar XF comfort was all what you well regarded, and this also iteration takes this to some new level. Most obvious will be the increased interior space, regardless of the overall reduction within the XF's length and height. A sizable 51mm wheelbase increase has liberated more room for passengers, particularly inside back, while decreasing the seat itself has grown headroom too. The Jaguar XF will genuinely carry 4 6-foot-tall adults with relative ease. 3 adults abreast about the back seat might remain a trickier proposition, though. Those seats are new to the generation XF and appear taller and sportier, but they are no less comfortable correctly. The XF's stiffer body causes it to become inherently quieter inside, with less chance of squeaks and rattles to produce, as the soft closed door option prevents louder slams. The cabin is lighter plus more airy as a result of an increased glass area, including the third side window behind the spine door. The added benefit from which may be the door itself may be more upright, healthy, making getting back in and out easier. 2 damper types are offered with all the Jaguar XF suspension. The standard dampers provide an even more supple ride at lower speeds, along with a stiffer one at high speeds to help you handling to stop the car wallowing along over motorway undulations. While it's effective, the superior adaptive dampers allow drivers to change between different numbers of firmness. Even in sport mode, as the ride isn't quite as cosseting such as comfort mode, it's still pleasantly supple. Even the XFS, using its improved handling, doesn't request you to compromise on comfort. Despite delivering a much more agile, sharper drive, the easiest version of Jaguar's saloon is usually a smooth rider on all nevertheless the most broken surfaces. Decent numbers of standard equipment through the range. All have modern finishes except the regular portfolio. In selection of expensive options makes it possible to tailor the spec. There are 4 familiar Jaguar trim levels inside the XF hierarchy: Prestige, Sport, Portfolio and S. Standard Jaguar XF saloon equipment. Entry trim could be the grandly titled Prestige grade, which secures chrome surround towards the front grille and side vents, rear parking sensors, 17-inch lightweight alloy wheels, Bixxon on headlamps with integral LED day running lights and indicators, auto lights and wipers, keyless ignition, cruise control with speed limiter, leather seats with a power recline within the heated front bear, leather-wrapped multifunction controls, automatically dimming rear view mirror, aluminium dashboard trim complemented by way of a gloss black veneer, in-control infotainment system with the 8.0-inch touchscreen. With Sport, the offer is, unsurprisingly, focused towards a far more athletic image. Sport body kit and spoiler. Dark satin exterior finish. 17-inch turbine or 18-inch helix alloys. Stiffer sports suspension arrangement. Leather seats with contrasting stitching. Dark headlining. Metal finish pedals. Portfolio specification introduces some additional luxury touches within a manner more connected with Jaguar saloons of old. Electrically heated windscreen. Keyless entry. Reversing camera. Front parking sensors. Automatically dimming and folding door mirrors. 17-inch aerodynamic alloys, or 18-inch fan design on better models. Leather seats electrically adjustable within the front. Leather dashboard with shiny figured ebony trim. Luxurious carpet mats. 380 watt meridian head unit. Topping the number are the V6 engine and S models, which combine portions of both their sport and portfolio along with their own unique touches. More aggressive S body kit. Adaptive dynamics. Sport suspension. 19-inch razor alloy wheels. Red brake calipers. Electrically adjustable sport seats. 40 hours 20 minutes 40 seconds split rear seats. Dark hex aluminium trim finish. Matte gray figured ebony veneer trims. Optional Jaguar XF saloon accessories. One aspect from the Jaguar XF specification makeup is always that, like its German rivals, there's so much with regard to extra cost options which can be standard on less expensive cars. Individual options depends within the trim level you're preparing, but highlights include metallic and premium palette paints, a suite of alloy wheel choices around 20 inches in diameter, different color leather, aluminium trim and veneer options. Plus you can adaptive cruise control with braking function, adaptive suspension, self-parking function, a power sunroof and, the very first Jaguar to possess them, full LED headlamps. Additionally, an array of bundles can be purchased grouping popular options together within a better value package. Active safety pack, a variety of adaptive cruise control, lane keep aid and driver condition monitoring to evaluate the driver's tiredness, lane change merge aid and cross traffic alert when easing backwards beyond parking bays. Advanced parking assist pack with surround camera system. In addition for the front parking sensors, the rest includes a 360-degree camera view, with self-park function, park exit facility and junction view camera permitting you to see left and right while you nose outside of tight spaces. Black pack, only accessible on R-Sport and S versions, it has a gloss black grille surround and front wing vents and, for that R-Sport, gloss black front bumper blades and boot lid spoiler. Cold climate pack, consists of an electrically heated windscreen plus heating elements for your washer jets, tire and front and back seats. Head-up display pack, laser-based head-up display HUD function through an infrared reflecting windscreen. In control touch pro pack with Meridian digital sound system, includes an aftermarket 10-inch infotainment touchscreen plus a 12.3-inch adaptable digital instrument display with either 380 watts or 825 watts of power with the upgraded subwoofer. Memory pack with power fold mirrors, automatically dimming and electrically folding door mirrors, filled with puddle lamps. Fully adjustable electric front seats employ a memory function too. Rogues only about the driver's side for Prestige and R-Sport XFs. Parking pack, exclusively about the Prestige trim, its content has front parking sensors along with a reversing camera. Power convenience pack, keyless entry and initiate function, combined through an electrically raising and lowering boot lid, with two additional 12-volt sockets, one from the boot itself, the other from the rear on the car. Rear comfort pack, heated back and front seats are complemented by 4-zone climate control, manual blinds on the spine doors and a power blind for a corner window. Full 5-star crash test score from Euro NCAP. An inherently safe executive saloon. Further safety kit is elective. When crash tested with the safety experts at Euro NCAP, Jaguar XF was awarded the full 5-star rating. All XFs have 6 airbags, electronic stability control, lane departure warning, pedestrian contact sensing bonnet, all-surface progress control, extra traction at low speeds for automatic versions, traffic sign recognition plus a pair of ISOFIX Child C8 mounting points inside the back. A suite of further options are offered in 2 from the optional packages. Integral towards the advanced parking assist option is really a 360-degree camera function, including self-park and drive-out facilities, and a junction view camera which splits the screen to exhibit what's for the left and right because you ease outside of obscure junctions. Second will be the appropriately titled active safety packs, such as adaptive cruise control to evaluate the speed with the vehicles right in front, in addition to lane keep aid LKA and driver condition monitoring DCM to appraise the apparent state of alertness in the driver. A reverse traffic detect feature, sensing the oncoming presence of vehicles since you back out of an parking space, is usually integral to this particular pack. More space for individuals and luggage on this occasion. Top spec models employ a 40 hours 20 minutes 40 seconds split rear seat. Plenty of storage cubbies inside upmarket cabin. Given the sleekness of the four-door coupe-like profile, you'd be forgiven for imagining Jaguar XF practicality will not be particularly impressive. There's a few usefully sized storage areas. There's a rubber back 12 in front from the gear lever, some cup holders within the center console plus a hinged armrest that reveals a number of USB ports plus a 12-volt charging point. Rear parking sensors come as part with the package of models, while higher-end trims additionally use a complementary set for the front plus a reversing camera too. A 360-degree camera system and self-parking might be added at extra expense. This generation of XF carries a larger aperture than before, allowing better access for the 540-liter capacity boot. As standard, all portfolio and S specification models optional around the others possess a 40:20:40 split rear seat back, allowing longer, more awkward loads being carried without difficulty. An electric boot lid can be obtained or standard, depending about the trim, precisely the same for keyless entry, although all XFs are started for the push of any button.